Hello and welcome to Cologne. This is Robbie Williams. Oh no, this is JP speaking. We're laughing about it, but I'll tell you why, actually, in a few minutes. But welcome to Cologne, and it's the annual convention of the Eurovision Club Germany. Next to us is now a lady that has been on the Eurovision stage in 2013. She is not native to her country she represented. She actually was born in Connecticut in the USA. She has Brazilian and Irish veins in her blood. Next to us, Natalia Kelly from Austria. Hello, Natalia.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm great, thank you.
So, welcome to Cologne, and how did you actually enjoy Cologne so far?
It was really nice. I didn't get to see much of the city, but driving from the airport to the hotel, I saw some very nice things, like the cathedral, and it was really beautiful. So I hope to get to do some sightseeing today.
And I can recommend you, like I did with Ryan Dolan as well, you have to go up the cathedral.
Oh,
it's
okay.
Amazing.
I certainly will.
The Cologne Cathedral hosts the biggest bell of all
really?
On Earth. Yes.
Amazing.
St. Peter's bell, and
okay.
You'll be really amazed when you're in front of it.
Okay, great.
So that's a little thing. However, no lift, you have to walk up there.
Oh,
509 stairs.
Oh, well, I'll think about it.
Fantastic. The reason why, because you told me, or your mother told me, that actually you thought it was Robbie Williams talking to you in London.
You pretty look like Robin Williams.
Is that really like that?
Yeah.
Okay,
so. And you're funny as well, so.
Tell you a secret, I am.
Oh, gosh.
So, let's start with your life before Eurovision.
Mm-hmm.
What did you do? How did you find out you were becoming a singer, or you wanted to become a singer?
Well, when I was 8, I decided that I wanted to do music as my professional career. And so I just kept on working on it. I write songs, I met new people, I had many shows, was part of some competitions. And then just after 10 years of hard work and really discipline, it finally got to this point where I'm at a record label, I have my own album, I was at the Eurovision Song Contest 2013, so it's all going pretty well.
Amazing. But what inspired you to become a singer? Is there like an idol, a music idol, that is, I want to be like that person?
Well, I have many idols, but one of my biggest is Celine Dion. But when I was small, I wanted to become a singer, or a vet, or sports. I wanted to do sports. But then after we went to the vet with my cat, and I saw him giving my cat an injection, I said, no, I cannot do that, so I'm just going to stay with the music. And so from that point on, I just started to do music.
You're pretty young, and found out yesterday that you were going to do your matura, which is like the A-level?
Yeah, the last year of school.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And then after that, what is the plan to do?
Well, after that, just continue on with my music, maybe record some more songs, a new album, but I'm really concentrating on school right now. I'm doing a lot of shows as well, but school is my number one priority right now, so I can finish and finally be done with school.
And then singing for the rest of your life.
Yes, for sure.
Is there actually anybody you'd like to sing together with?
Oh my gosh, well, I love to sing with a lot of famous singers. Well, I'd love to sing with Celine Dion one day. That would be a really, really great, great accomplishment.
What made you go to enter into the national final of Austria for the Eurovision?
Well, my producer, he actually suggested it to me. He said, well, think about it. It would be a great, great chance because I want to become an international singer. Mm-hmm. And so it was really a good idea. I got to expose myself and I met so many new people and had so many great experiences. So I'm really thankful for this chance.
Although you didn't qualify Austria for the grand final, you did number 14 in the semi-final.
Yeah.
I think the song was really fantastic, really
Thank
good,
you.
Good song. And do you think that Eurovision has actually helped you with your career in that respect?
Yes, for sure. So it really also helped me just to gain a personal experience and also to expose myself. So I learned so much, so it was really nice.
You are very young, I mentioned that before, and the thought of standing on the stage in a hall that has 28,000 viewers, audience, and then millions of people watching you, doesn't that scare you at all?
Not a bit. I don't have stage fright. I love to be on stage, and I'm just like positive and nervous a little bit because I want to go on stage. I want to sing and to perform. So I can't wait for the show today, so it's going to be really, really cool.
That's amazing. Malmö this year, how did you experience the Eurovision craze? Do you have any stories you can share with us? Any funny bits or any things that were not so nice for you?
I only have some good experiences in Malmö. I can't think of anything that was negative. I had very much fun with my crew. We were always everywhere. We did a lot of sightseeing as well. And so it was really nice. I got to see a bit of the country of Malmö and I loved it. It's a very beautiful city. And I also had a lot of this crazy Eurovision world that was fascinating for me. So I loved it a lot.
Did you have any contact to any previous Austrian Eurovision performers telling you how it's best to go about this?
I met Trashitas. Mm-hmm. And they told me a little bit about it, they told me it's a crazy world and you're gonna have a lot of fun, and it was even better than I expected when I got there, so I just loved it, and well, it's really amazing.
You're full of enthusiasm and energy, yeah. And I can really feel that, it's amazing, and keep that going. What gives you that energy?
I guess my mom, she's Brazilian, so she's also a bit crazy and energetic.
Don't say too loud, she's fantastic. Have you been in touch, or are you still in touch with any of the Eurovision performers from your year, from the semi-final or from the final?
A little bit sometimes, with Gianluca from Malta. So we have both Instagram and some pictures, and then we could just comment. So, yeah.
Now, after the Eurovision, how has it continued for you?
Well, I had a lot of exams to do in school, so to finish the 11th grade, and I did. Then we had summer vacation, and I was in America with my grandmother, and I did a lot of shows, and then school started again, so I'm studying a lot, but also doing a lot of shows.
If people want to find out more about you, how can they do that? You have a website where they can find out the new album, new single you're putting on the market?
Just Facebook me, Natalia Kelly, and then you can read everything about me.
It's amazing, Facebook.
It's a
mind of knowledge, this is. Any time for hobbies?
Hobbies, well, music is my hobby. It's like really my only one hobby I have, actually. Well, I like to go out with friends and to the movies and play with my cats, but music is my world.
Amazing. One day will be the time you cannot sing anymore. What will you be doing then?
Well, I don't want to think of that day because that would be a very, very sad day. I don't know what I would do. I actually don't want to think about it.
No plan B? So that'd be like to go back to become a vet at the end?
No plan B, actually. Music is my plan A.
Over the years, Eurovision, you've been following Eurovision since when?
Since I was a little girl, I guess. Since I was 5 or 6 years old. We moved to Austria when I was 5. So about that time, we started watching TV here in Austria. So I always watched it almost every year. It's kind of like a family tradition. Mm-hmm. We used to sit down with popcorn and just, oh, cool, cool music.
How will you celebrate or be experiencing the upcoming Eurovision Song Contest in Copenhagen? Will you be going to Copenhagen, or will you be watching it at home with friends, family?
Well, I hope I get the chance to go to Copenhagen and watch it there live, but let's see, because of my school. Mm-hmm. So I got a lot of exams around that time, so I have to really coordinate it well, but I hope I get to go.
Fantastic. Natalia, thank you very much for giving us the interview.
Thank you.
Great to see you again, and I wish you all the best of luck for your upcoming career, for your school first.
Thanks.
And then that you sell well, many albums, perform well. Are you planning any international tours?
Yeah, maybe after school. Mm-hmm. So we're working on that, but like I said, priority number one is to finish school, and then I'm free to do so much music and record new songs, so I'm really looking forward to that.
Amazing. We're looking forward to hearing much more from you.
Thank
Fantastic.
You.
Shining face.
Oh, thank you. Bye-bye.